Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here at Computex 2025 in the beautiful city of Taipei at the Gigabyte booth. And today with us, we have Andrew. Hey, Andrew, how's it going?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Yeah, Thanks for having us.
Yeah, of course, my pleasure. Yeah.
Thank you, thank you. So I see you have here two beautiful motherboards and some systems, and okay, let's take it away.
Yeah, we really have a lot of good things to share. Now, this is our Z890 Aorus Extreme. This is our flagship model that released like 2024 Q4 for the Aorus Z890 chipset. So we have everything on it, on power, connection, Wi-Fi, Thunderbolt, even Thunderbolt 5. And the extra DDR fan right here allows to have a battery cooling when you have an intensive overclocking with DDR. And we also have this one for the Chem2 module. Now this is a concept design that is on the Z890 Aorus Tychyon ICE. Still a concept design, but we feel like it's really good to have the concept to reality. So as we can see a live system over here, underneath we have a Chem2 module design compared with the ordinary UD module. Mm-hmm. It's totally different. Yeah. So we can see the good performance leap compared with the UD. So we're really excited to share this. Yeah.
No, that is great. It's beautiful. Like you said, this is mostly focused for overclockers, right?
Yeah.
As you can see, well, different features here for changing the frequency. And I can see that you completely redesigned this motherboard compared to the other ones because you have rotated like 90 degrees counterclockwise to make sure you have a better, I guess, routing traces when it comes to the memory side.
Yeah, great observation, Alex. So for us, when Tychyon ICE is the overclocking intensive, we're trying to break record with the Tychyon series of the motherboard. So that's why we moved the routing from the here for the DDR side to the top side in order to get shorter routing of the layout and get the signal transition faster to the CPU and to get everything done in fast and performance with elegance.
Yeah, that is great. Like, cause like you said, the shorter traces, it's easier to get higher frequency, less signal degradation. So it's pretty awesome.
Indeed, yeah.
What do you have here? Is that the M.2s?
Yeah, this is the M.2 and it's totally screwless design of the easy DIY feature, as you can see right here. And
oh, nice.
We have two M.2 slots underneath, and it's for sure it supports our Gen 5 speed as well, not like Gen 5 by 4 speed. Yeah, yeah.
That is great. So you have the M.2, the quick release for the PCIe,
yes,
for the video card.
Yes,
it's,
of course.
It's complete. Okay, so here's where you guys are at. This is the allegedly concept, but I can see you already have a full running model here.
Yes, this one right here is the Z90 UDIM version of the Tychyon ICE. Actually, high cookie or overclocker used the very same motherboard to break the DDR warp record of the 12,752 MT per second. And he used pretty much the same motherboard and keep breaking the warp record right now ongoing. And we know that he needs some work on that. Maybe we'll see more exciting results. And it has the same design on the moving the DDR from the side to the top for better memory routing as well. Right now, the system is running for 9733 MT per second and with a memory test. So actually, it's running up, not a screenshot. You can still use that and do some settings, do some tunings. Also, the greatest part is that it supports the Intel 200S boost as well.
Nice, this is great. So actually, that's a great point that you bring up. So we were talking earlier and you said like all your Z890 motherboards are 200 boost ready for it.
Yes, of course, because we already want to have a good partnership and relationship with Intel. So we know that Intel has published such kind of good technology and innovation on the Intel 200S boost. So we have implemented that all in our Z890 chipset and it's all on website right now.
That is great. Okay, Andrew, I think you have something else you want to show us over there, which caught us our eye. So let's move over there. Okay, Andrew.
Yeah.
So you said you have one more thing you want to show us.
Yeah.
This is a lovely laptop. Tell us a little bit more about it.
Yes, this is Aorus 16 with Intel Core Ultra 927HX and also with a 32G RAM, with SSD. And it has a lot of good things happening, not only with the thermal good screen, and also you have an extra support with Thunderbolt 5. It's really insane on the connectivity and expansion ability of this laptop. Yeah,
this laptop looks like it's a great laptop when it comes to content creators.
Yeah.
Especially because, like you just said, it has a Thunderbolt 5, so that is great to transfer data back and forward, and also gives you other capabilities. And it's, like you said, a 275HX, which has a lot of power behind it, a lot of cores, so it looks great. And as we can see here, actually, you're running Comfy UI, right?
Yeah, of course. I'm running Comfy UI with an extra like AI box right here. This is also something we have launched during our launch event like a few days ago.
Oh, nice.
So it has another like a very powerful VGA card, RTX VGA card mounted inside the box. So whether you can take it at the workplace or you bring it at home for the gaming, it's all always okay compared or like a bundle with this Aorus 16 laptop.
Yeah. This is great. Like you said, thanks to Thunderbolt 5, you can actually connect to an external graphics card if you need more power. Like you can have this at home.
Yeah.
And if you need more power, you're able to connect this. And you can, and then if you need to travel, there's some other stuff, just bring this with you and it will be a great companion.
Yes, we really would like to expand or try to explore more possibility on how people or user or workers to use their own PC, whether on gaming, content creation, or even on the workload. Yeah.
No, this is great.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to touch, like for the screen and storage?
On the storage wise, we have like one TB of the M.2 slots, and also we still have other expansion slot ability on that as well. And the connectivity right here, we have the also with the support with the Wi-Fi, of course, and the LAN connect as well. Yeah.
That is great. I don't want to unplug it, but actually, over here I can see one of my favorite features, which is a full Ethernet port, our RJ45.
Yeah.
You have your HDMI.
Yeah.
You have USB C Type A, and we already talked about the Thunderbolt 5.
Also, we have the Type C right here, and there's an extension of the USB as well. Yeah.
Yeah, and you have I think that's a micro SD, which, like we said, it's great for content creators.
Yes, of course.
Andrew, thank you so much. I think we're gonna go check out some other laptops over there. But I'd like to say thank you for having us here. Thank you for your time.
Yeah,
it's been great. Love all the systems that we have seen, the motherboard, the laptop, and also the external GPU. So thank you so much.
Yeah, glad you like it. Glad you like it, Alex. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you. All right, and we're back, and we are here at the Gigabyte booth with Diana. Hi, Diana. How's it going?
Very well. Yourself?
Doing great. Thank you. I see you have two amazing laptops, and you want to talk to us about it?
Yes, definitely.
Why don't we start? Let's start with the big one.
Yes, so this is what we call Aorus Master 18, which obviously is the most high-end product in our Aorus product line, which featuring the top-tier processor, the Ultra 9 275HX, and also the top-tier graphic card up to 1590. So I think everyone are looking for the maximum performance nowadays, so obviously we need to give it the maximum we can. Also, this machine features the mini LED display with a super ultra contrast ratio up to 1 million to 1, believe it or not. So it will be able to deliver the highest visual experience to it, not just for playing, but also for creator who needs like very extremely, you know, accuracy on their screens.
Yeah, so I think this is what we will, I mean, sometimes we could call it like a desktop replacement. And like you said,
yes,
it's great,
yes,
great for creators because it has a lot of those features. Like you have a very powerful processor, you have
That's correct.
The I/O that you need. And also, like you said, the screen resolution is amazing. And you also have like a discrete card. So it's like everything that you need to. Of course, this is it's not live, but this is what you want when you're traveling to different places and created some content.
Yes.
But this is a great desktop replacement.
Yeah, I would say that's very true. Like, even though you might think it's still a big chunk of it, but I'm saying, even if you experience how amazing it is, we are able to deliver up to 270 watts thermal performance, which we have tested for several times, and also all the reviews online approve that our 5080 actually achieved pretty much a similar performance up to 1590 compared to other people. So we are making sure that this machine will be able to deliver the best to our clients and customers.
Yeah. And I think it does a great job because we were talking earlier and you were saying like it goes up to 6 terabytes when it comes to memory space, which is great for content creators for like high resolution videos.
Yes, that's correct.
You also have Thunderbolt connectivity.
Yes.
And RAM, 128, right?
128. So we actually have 4 slots for people to do the expansion.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, I think like nowadays there's no more requirements on those features, so we're trying to see how the market feels the needs for that. And also you just mentioned about the Thunderbolt solutions, where we definitely have to apply the latest Thunderbolt 5, which give us a much better display performance up to 2.1, and then also the 3.0 PD power delivery. Yeah.
No, oh, that's great. Okay, so this is the Aorus Masters 18, which is a beautiful system.
Yes.
I see you also have another one over here.
Yes, so We're going to talk about the summer performance in a very short minute. So I will introduce what we call the A16 Pro from Gigabyte Gaming, which normally people believe our Gigabyte Gaming is for like a bit more like entry or starters, where we would like to also implement something a bit different, which might be still be very rare on the market, which is the 5080 graphic cards.
Right.
Because definitely the Aorus is the massive chunk where we still want to deliver something maybe that's more friendly for students who want to work on their projects or like doing some live codings or AI models, something like that. So the A16 Pro will be perfect for them, which both of them will be sharing what we call the Windforce Infinity EX solutions, which will be one of our exclusive design thermal solutions covering different types of, you know, thermals. It might be explained a bit later. Yeah.
No, that is great. So you're talking about the thermal solutions that we have back here,
yes,
right? So this is a great display. I love the display, I think, what you guys have done here. So you're saying the fans that were designed for the Aorus Master are implemented in the other
one? Yes, that's correct. So this is what we call the frost fan. So it means it will be cooled on this machine very efficiently. Normally, we are limited to maybe around 100 blades, just because more blades could block the thermal solutions. Where we actually make this one exclusively in-house design, where we use a symmetric blade here. You can see it is like in different like shapes, which actually increase air pressure. So what it does is like it will be able to push out the hot air much more efficient than like just regular fans. So by applying this one, our A16 Pro will be able to maintain the same chassis with the A16, which only focus up to 5070. So we actually improve the thermal performance without increase the thickness of the machine. So we want to showcasing the overall solutions from Gigabyte, so we're able to deliver a much better advanced technology.
That's great. I mean, that reminds me pretty much how a lot of the Formula One, like a lot of the development gets created in those race cars, but then throughout the years gets to the regular cars. And that's what you did here. You grabbed this amazing Halo product, developed the fans for it, and like, you know what? We can use them in the lower.
I think that shared a similar concept, like the airflow, air pressure to push the performance to the next level.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's like the great concept. Yeah.
That is great. Another thing that I want to call out for the Aorus Master 18, which I thought was pretty neat. This guy, I really love this display. We have here, you can see from this guy's here, so these are vapor chambers that help a lot of dissipation of the heat. This one right here is going to be for, if I recall correctly,
yes,
I'll show the motherboard. This is for the graphics card, and this is for the actual for the processor. So you can see also the heat pipe distribution, where the fans are going to be, and they're going to go to blow the air through there. So I really, really like this display a lot.
Yes, and maybe this one we'll talk more about how we actually display, like we are able to achieve the highest thermal performance is like what we call internal blasting system. So on our Master 18, we actually have two more little fans here. And what it does is like it blow the all the hot like winds from the same directions.
Mm-hmm.
Because imagine inside, it could be all the place.
Right.
So to ensure that it is going the same direction, it will always go through our vapor chamber.
Right.
So it starts to get in the cold, like cold winds, and then get rid of all the heats from the back.
Puts it up there.
Yeah, so from this picture, it will be much easier to show you how the airflow direction goes.
It's great. It seems like here's the intake with the help of the two fans,
yes,
and you're gonna go through the back and also a little bit through the sides.
Yes, that's correct. Because by doing all of these, we actually be able to reach it up to 4.7 degrees Celsius lower than other people.
That's great.
That's a significant numbers of improvement.
Yeah, that is huge. It gives you a lot of more performance, allows you to stay in higher frequencies, turbo for a lot longer. So yes, it's a lot of performance doing there. And just because I want to geek out a little bit more, I want to show you guys the motherboard. Oh my God, here is the motherboard. You have here your GPU, here you have your 275HX. As you were saying, you have your four memory DIMMs
that
you can actually,
correct,
as you can see, you actually replace them, upgrade if you want. You have your M.2s and, you know, I'll show you guys. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, you have the I/O ports, whereas the Thunderbolts on both ways. Yes.
I love it that we can actually get to see not only the heating, how it's broken into a part, but also the motherboard. It's an engineering marvel. Diana, thank you so much for having us here.
It's very nice to meet you guys and I'm so welcoming everyone to join the suite to be able to share all the new products with us.
Thank you so much, and great to have you, and thanks for having us.